Welcome to Orchard Beginner. In this video, we will be exploring the admin dashboard of Orchard. Welcome back. Let's click on the dashboard link to browse to the admin dashboard of Orchard. The first link is the dashboard link, which allows you to come back to the main dashboard of Orchard if you are on any of these sections. For example, like if you click on the blog link, you will be navigated to the blogs area where you can create a new blog. And if you want to go back to the main page of the dashboard, then you can click on this dashboard link. Next, the new section allows you to create new instances of default content types. For example, like a page. If you want to create a page, just click on this page and you can create a page. Similarly for the projection. The content tab allows you to manage or create new content items. For example, if you want to create a new content item, click on this create new content and then you can select your content type and you can create content items. The content definition section allows you to manage existing content types as well as create new content types. For creating, you can click on create new types. We will be talking about these things, for example, how to create a content type, how to create a content part, how to create a content field. We'll be talking about these things in the later on videos. This video is specially to help you navigate around, help you to explore around the admin dashboard of Orchard. Blog allows you to create a new blog and then you can create blog posts inside those blogs. You can have multiple blogs. The query tab allows you to create new queries or remove existing queries, and these queries can be projected using the projection content type. Next is the comments. It will allow you to manage all your comments for your blogs. Taxonomy allows you to create taxonomies, and now this helps you to categorize your content items in Orchard. Again, we will be talking about these things in the later on videos. Widgets allows you to create different kinds of widgets different kinds of layers. There are different layers: authenticated, anonymous, default, disabled, and homepage. So you can select any of these layers and then you can add your widgets to any of the zones. Next is the media. The media tab allows you to manage all your images and other types of media files. Then navigation. The navigation tab helps you to create menus and add menu items to those menus. There are different ways to add menus to your menu in Orchard. We will be talking about these methods to add menus. Then we have tags. This allows you to create tags. You can write a name of a tag and then click add. Then we have the modules section. This allows you to manage your modules, install new modules, download new modules, you can even go to the gallery and then you can download a module and then click on the install tab and then install it from your computer. Then we have the layouts section. This allows you to create a layout for your page or for your blog or for your own content type in Orchard. We will be talking about layouts later on. Then we have the themes section, which allows you to enable, disable, and download themes in Orchard. Then we have the workflow section. This allows you to create workflows in Orchard. And then we have the users area, which allows you to create new users. It allows you to create roles and give permissions for your users. Then we have the reports, which lets you manage and view reports that Orchard generates for your website. For example, we installed this website a few minutes back, and this is the report generated by Orchard. So now for some things in Orchard will generate a report, which you can go to this section of the dashboard and have a look at it. Last is the settings. This area will help you to manage your website. It will help you to configure a variety of site settings, such as the site name, the culture, the default number of items per page. This is here. And maximum number of items per page, the gallery feed, and then comment settings, media settings, and user settings. This section will allow you to give permissions to new users to create account on your website. And then it will, if you want to approve the user before they log in, you can even select this checkbox. And then last is the cache setting, which allows you to create caching duration for your website. So this was just a brief video about exploring the dashboard of Orchard. And in the next video, we will be installing Orchard using IIS and SQL Server. Thank you.